Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Rocket Monday. Today we're gonna take a look at Chinese space program, so let's dive right into it. As you can see, it was established in 22 April 1993. Now, to be fair, it's not that young. There used to be multiple organizations before that, but it was compiled, restructured and made into the current CNSA, that is China's National Space Administration, that generally takes care of China's space business. Now, a lot of reconstruction was done simply because they wanted to remove all of inefficiencies, and they basically learned from Western world, where government and private companies were working together to optimize performance. This was the main reason why it was restructured. And they have a sort of philosophy, and the philosophy is very government owned, but not government managed. The private company managed, because they are much more faster, efficient. So this is how they delegate things. So why does China need, you know, a space program? China wasn't always the superpower that it became today, and that was the core reason of Chinese space program. They wanted to make sure China becomes a super. This was the dream of Mao's. And Mao actually used to think that Western world did not respect him, and this was a kind of personal dream, like, and specifically after the Cold War, when Russia and America were like so powerful that almost no one else is on the table, he wanted to make sure nuclear program is there and a nuclear war, nuclear launch facility is also there, because while nuclear bomb is kind of easy to make, the ICBM that is needed to carry it is not cheap or easy to make. So you need your own space program. Nobody's gonna share you, you know, ICBM technology. So he established this idea, and they, because they were a kind of new kid in the block, they did not have a lot of technical expertise or experience. So they made a partnership with USSR, not Russia, USSR, the Soviet Union basically. And it was done in 1950s. So for roughly 10 to 15 years, they had a cooperative technology transfer, where Soviet Union was allowing Chinese people to come and learn under them. So using this, China got a huge boost. So their space program went jumped a few steps of development directly, because they were, you know, helped by USSR. So you have to understand, China is not a loved country. When you say China, nobody comes and say, oh, China is awesome. The simple reason is because it does not have democracy. Basically, people can't vote. Like, voting is there just for the show, because, like, you know, there is no other party. The politics is very complicated, and simplest sense, it's not a capitalist world, it's a communist world. And if history tells us anything, is communist world don't last very long, and they have a lot of blood cost. Suffice to say, China also had paid that blood cost, so it's not very loved country. And NASA flat out banned them in International Space Station, simply citing conflict of national security and all that. So they were not allowed to inhabit International Space Station. And the biggest black mark they have is what's called unknown funding. Now, this is a part of their politics. They say their space agency is running on $500 million, but anybody who knows how expensive rockets are will be like, dude, that budget is way too low. Now, this sort of thing is common in military, but not common in space. Specifically, if you want to claim that you are a peaceful organization, this sort of thing is not acceptable. So there are some of black marks there. And Soviet Union, after that was dissolved, they did not continue their partnership with Russia, and it was ended in 1960. But they have managed some great achievements and some very successful milestones. So let's look into them. So their current breadwinner, so to say, is Long March rocket families, and as you can see, this rocket launch, and it has same lifting capacity as Falcon 9. So it's kind of heavy lift rocket, and they are building some versions where they will have Long March 9, which will able to carry 150 ton into low Earth orbit. That's more than Falcon Heavy and almost the same capacity as BFR. So their Long March rocket family is quite successful, and it is their current breadwinner, so to say. And they are the only country after Russia, America, they are the third country to build their own space station. Like, International Space Station is built by collaboration with European Space Agency, Canada, Japan, like a lot of other countries, you know, chipped in a little bit, and USA was the, you know, prime management of that, but it was not completely independent. However, before that, USA also built Skylab, so USA has the experience to build their own space station. Russia also has the ability to build their own space station. China became the third one to do so. So this is quite a big achievement. Like building your own spaceship, building your own space station is not cheap or easy. So they became the third one to do it, and they did a manned mission also in 2003. This man is the one that did became the first Chinese astronaut, or taikonaut as they are called, to, you know, go to space. And this put China on a world level. Like, this is an achievement that cannot be understated. Like, you can have rockets, you can have heavy lift rocket, European agency does that, but they do not have their own manned space program. So this puts it ahead of European space agency. So suffice to say, it's a quite a big achievement. So this was my quick summary of Chinese space space corporation, so to say. So I hope you like this presentation or learn from it, in which case please like. If you didn't, dislike, leave a comment and subscribe. I make video every day, and thanks for watching.